Anaheim Ducks and the San Jose Sharks will face off as two of the four Pacific Division representatives in the NHL playoffs. With the league's realignment a few years ago, the number two and number three seeds within a division now play each other. So the Ducks host the Sharks after edging San Jose by just 1 point in the standings. Perhaps San Jose doesn't care where the series is played, since the Sharks racked up 7 of 8 possible points in this season series. But 3 of those games required shootouts. In other words, buckle up for a tight series. The Ducks certainly earned their way into the playoffs by winning 5 straight in 8 of the last 10 to not only get in, but be at home in game number 1. The Sharks scuffled a bit down the stretch, but were safely in the postseason for a while before officially punching a ticket. These two teams are very familiar with each other, but have not faced off in the playoffs since 2009. As you would expect, this series is a virtual toss-up, with the Ducks getting home ice advantage. The Ducks once again made things hard on themselves this season with a slow start. Through 28 games, the Ducks were just 11-11-6, but Anaheim finished 33-14-7 to make it to the playoffs for the 6th straight season and the 11th time in the last 13 years. Anaheim is offensively challenged and was a bit of an overachiever. The Ducks played more like a team that was minus 10 in goal differential at 5-on-5 than a team that was plus 23, which the Ducks actually were. They did not rate well per the advanced metrics, which is why we have seen some initial investment on San Jose for the series. This really isn't one of the stronger Ducks teams on the surface. Corey Perry's offense is dried up, as he only had 17 goals in 71 games. Jacob Silverberg was limited to 17 goals. Rickard Raskel was the only 30-goal scorer and the only player with more than 20 goals. Ryan Getzlaff only had 11 goals in his 56 games and failed to score on the power play. Anaheim did excel at preventing goals, but this feels like the wrong team is favored. John Gibson did not play at all during the final week of the season, so we do have some questions about the upper body injury that cost him that tune-up time. He left the game against Colorado after allowing 1 goal on 10 shots and has not played since April 1st. Ryan Miller has played extremely well, and the big stage would be nothing new for the 37-year-old, but he is 37 years old. Per Corsica Hockey, Gibson was second to Sergei Bobrovsky in goals saved above average this season, so his health is a big deal. The San Jose Sharks didn't make a whole lot of noise this season en route to the playoffs. The Sharks were solid as usual, but it took a while for Martin Jones to get going, and Joe Thornton missed about half the season. Thornton, who has been out since January 23rd, is unlikely to be ready for Game 1 on Thursday, but we'll see if he's able to get back out there at some point during the series. It would certainly help, as San Jose had a lot of balanced scoring, but missed Thornton's pace with 36 points in 47 games. Logan Couture was the only 30-goal scorer this season for the Sharks. Brent Burns led the way in points, and he is always active during the playoffs. He'll also lead the team in time on the ice and be a factor in all 3 zones. Against an offensively challenged team like the Ducks, guys like Burns and Justin Braun can be a little bit more aggressive. San Jose plays with a lot of speed up the wings, so we'll have to see how Anaheim can slow them down. Peter DeBoer seems to have a coaching advantage over Randy Carlyle, although Carlyle was behind the bench for Anaheim's Stanley Cup run in 2007. The Sharks are certainly motivated coming into the playoffs after last season's embarrassing effort in 6 games against the Edmonton Oilers and former head coach Todd McLellan. It was a big departure from the Stanley Cup run during the 2016 playoffs. Martin Jones may ultimately decide the team's ceiling. Jones was excellent in 2016, less excellent in 2017, and had a decent regular season with a 2.55 goals against average and a .915 save percentage. Jones was outplayed early in the year by Aaron Dell, but took his crease back and played well down the stretch. The wrong team is definitely favored in this series. San Jose rates far better in all of the advanced metrics. The one area where Anaheim seems to have an edge is in the net with John Gibson, but we'll have to wait and see how healthy he actually is to contribute. The Sharks are a better possession team and were better in both special teams areas, including on the penalty kill, where they have the 2nd-best shorthanded unit. Our pick and prediction is for San Jose to take this series in 6 games.